Hi viewers, welcome to ChemEasy. In this video, let us see reformat's key reaction and its mechanism. Before watching this video, subscribe ChemEasy to learn chemistry easily. In reformat's key reaction, carbonyl compounds, that is either aldehydes or ketones, reacts with zinc metal and alpha bromo ester to give beta hydroxy esters after hydrolysis. You can see the example, carbonyl compound with zinc and alpha bromo ester, that is ethyl bromo acetate, gives one intermediate product. This after hydrolysis gives beta hydroxy ester. This is a procedure involved in reformat's key reaction. Initially, mixture of the carbonyl compound, that is either aldehyde or ketone, alpha bromo ester and zinc metal in dry ether is gaseously heated under reflux. In this process, zinc will be dissolved completely and the zinc may be activated by adding traces of iodine, mercuric bromide or copper powder. Then the mixture is treated with ice cold dilute sulfuric acid and ether layer is separated. Then from the separated ether layer, ether is distilled off when beta hydroxy ester is obtained. In this reformat's key reaction, generally solvents like ether, benzene, toluene, tetrahydrofuran can be used, and in the place of zinc metal, activated indium, tin, zinc copper couple can also be used, and the aldehyde or ketone may be aliphatic, aromatic or heterocyclic, and it may contain various functional groups. These functional groups will not be affected during the reformat's key reaction. As we have seen in definition, in reformat's key reaction, beta hydroxy ester is not isolated frequently because this isolated product yields the corresponding unsaturated ester, and this unsaturated ester may be converted to saturated carboxylic acids. You can see the example, beta hydroxy ester, which is produced by reformat's key reaction, which gives unsaturated ester by dehydration. This unsaturated ester containing carbon-carbon double bond is subjected to hydrogenation. In this process, the double bond is saturated and the product after hydrolysis gives saturated carboxylic acid. Here let us see the mechanism of reformat's key reaction. Initially, metallic zinc added to alpha bromo ester and produces organo zinc derivative. In next step, this organo zinc derivative added to the carbonyl group of aldehyde or ketone and produces intermediate product. This on hydrolysis gives beta hydroxy esters. You can see the example. In carbonyl compound, the bielectron shifted to oxygen and it gets a negative charge, and the carbon atom will get positive charge. In organo zinc compound, the negatively charged carbon atom added to the positively charged carbon atom of carbonyl group and gives intermediate adduct. This intermediate adduct on hydrolysis produces beta hydroxy ester. This beta hydroxy esters readily undergo acid catalyzed dehydration and forms alpha beta unsaturated esters. You can see this example. First, the hydroxyl group of beta hydroxy ester is protonated, followed by dehydration produces carbon-carbon double bond containing unsaturated ester. There are some drawbacks in reformat's key reaction. A serious drawback of reformat's key reaction is the formation of beta keto esters as a side product by the self condensation of the alpha bromo ester. It means in this reaction, alpha bromo esters also used. This alpha bromo esters undergoes self condensation and produces beta keto esters as a side product. Suppose if you are using ketone instead of aldehyde, and the R group in ketone are very large, then the carbonyl group is sterically hindered and the reaction proceeds to form beta ketoesters, not beta hydroxyesters. If we are using aldehyde as a carbonyl compound, then the main reaction takes place and produces beta hydroxyester.